judicious thing for you to do is stop right there. You have to back off right there to prevent injuries from happening in the future. So this was all about compression. Now also, as yoga teachers, it is our duty to make students understand, make students learn about their own body, about their own body structure, and help them to understand what is stopping them. Lastly, the point that I wish to cover pertains to hypermobility. Now, speaking of hypermobility, most of you will be surprised to know that even hypermobility can be a cause of injury. Yes, it is true. Now, when we see yoga practitioners, yoga students from all over the world, everybody seems to be using yoga as a tool to gain more and more flexibility. Each one is using yoga as a tool to learn more and more advanced asanas. And the aftermath of this, unfortunately, is that sooner or later you will be inviting some kind of damage to your body. And what can this damage be? The damage will be in the form of hypermobile joints. Hypermobile joints are those joints which have lost their stability. They are flippy, floppy joints. If your joints are hypermobile, if your joints are unstable, it can lead to some grievous consequences in the future, such as some degenerative diseases or even injuries. Our joints need to have a certain amount or an appropriate amount of stability in order to function in the right, appropriate manner. Now, one thing that hypermobile practitioners tend to be doing a lot is hyperextending their joints. Now, what is this hyperextension? This is something that we'll see. Now, hyperextension is anything that is beyond straight. That is, when the angle between the joint or when the angle in the joint goes beyond 180 degrees, it is hyperextension. Now, once again, I'll be demonstrating this for you. Now, let me take the example of the elbow here. So, here is the elbow joint, and this angle between the upper arm and my forearm is 90 degrees. Now, from here, I'll go on straightening my forearm till I reach the angle of 180 degrees, which is a straight line. Now, because I have certain amount of hypermobility here, I can go beyond this 180 degrees. See, now this is no longer 180 degrees. Okay, so what I'm doing here is I'm hyperextending at my elbow joint. Now, let me show it to you once again. So here, this is an angle of 90 degrees. I go on straightening my forearm to reach a 180 degrees angle or a straight line. And from here, because I have that kind of range or hypermobility in the elbow joint, I am easily going beyond the 180 degrees. You see the slant over here? So this is definitely more than 180 degrees, and this is hyperextension. So when a person is hyperextending at the joint, what it means is that they are not engaging their muscles properly. It also means that there is no adequate muscle control. It means that they are simply hanging into their joints. And when a person is simply hanging into the joints, what they are doing is they are putting undue strain. They are putting undue stress on the connective tissues like the ligaments as well as the tendons. Now, as I said earlier, for a normal and a healthy person, a certain amount of stress to the ligaments and the tendons is healthy. But anything beyond that will lead to some kind of damage, will lead to some kind of injury. Now, again, with respect to flexibility, each yoga student and a practitioner ought to know the various types of connective tissues and their stretch tolerance. So I'll be speaking a little bit about three kinds of connective tissue. The first being tendons. Now, what are these tendons? Now, these tendons are bands of connective tissues which connect your muscle to bone. Now these tendons have a very little tolerance to being stretched. Now it is said that beyond a 4% stretch, these tendons can tear and they can also lengthen beyond their capacity to recoil. Therefore, it is advised not to stretch the tendons too much. Now the next kind of connective tissue is the ligaments. Now these ligaments are connective tissues which connect bone to bone. Now example of a ligament can be ACL in the knee, that is the anterior cruciate ligament or the posterior cruciate ligament, or maybe the lateral collateral ligament, and so many ligaments there. So the purpose of these ligaments is that they help stabilize the joints. So because they play such a crucial role in joint stability, it is not recommended to stretch the ligaments as well. Although the ligaments can stretch a wee bit more than the tendons, it is recommended that the ligaments should not be stretched too much, because once again it will lead to instability or hypermobility in the joints, which is not desirous at all. Lastly, we'll come to muscle fascia. Now what is this muscle fascia? Now muscle fascia is like a web or a network of connective tissue that is pervading the entire spectrum of our human body. So your fascia is that which is keeping everything together. So I can say that your fascia is more or less like a stocking which is holding everything together like one cohesive unit. Now, out of all the structural components of the body, it is this muscle fascia that can be stretched safely. And all the gains that one derives out of stretching is owing to a proper stretching of the muscle fascia. Okay, so this was about the connective tissues and their stretch tolerance. Now you have to understand that flexibility has to be worked along with strength. This is very important, especially for hypermobile practitioners. Now I'll be speaking of a couple of practices which hypermobile practitioners can deploy on a day-to-day basis in order to have a safe and in order to have a practice which they can carry on for the long term. So the first thing that hypermobile practitioners need to do in their yoga asanas is that they need to keep a slight micro bend in their joints. Okay, now let me demonstrate this for you. I'll take the example of Marjarasana and I'll show it to you. So now I'm on all my fours over here. So in Marjarasana, your hips and the knees are aligned. Your shoulders and the wrists are aligned. Now many a times what I see is that the inside of the elbows, it is turned out and the student or the practitioner is simply dumping the weight into the elbows like this. So when you are doing this, what you are doing is you are simply loading or straining the ligaments therein, which will cause some kind of instability in your joint eventually. So what hypermobile practitioners or practitioners who are used to this kind of position of the elbows need to do is they need to turn the inside of the elbows towards each other and maintain a slight micro bend. A micro bend is something that is very minimal and it may be apparent only to you. So when you have this micro bend, you're ensuring that the stability of your joint is not compromised. So this is the first thing that hypermobile practitioners need to do in their day-to-day practice. Now the second thing which is very vital for hypermobile practitioners is that they need to choose their styles of yoga very wisely. Now it will be prudent for them to incorporate something like power yoga or hatha yoga into their day-to-day practice so that they can work equally on the strength element as well, right? And they can do away with or refrain from a yin yoga class where there's too much of stretching happening or where there is too much of stretching happening at your tendons, at the ligaments, so they can avoid that and focus more on strength building along with their flexibility. Now coming to the third point which hypermobile practitioners can do is they have to practice at 80% of their range. So when they are practicing, they have to restrain from reaching their end ranges of motion and they have to stop at 80% of their range. That means they need to back off a little bit. Now once again, let me show it to you. Now I'll be taking the example of Adhomukha Svanasana and I'll demonstrate it for you. Now in Adhomukha Svanasana, what a hypermobile practitioner will tend to do is you will go down all the way like this till the crown of the head touches the floor. So note carefully what is happening. I am loading my wrists excessively. My elbows are into hyperextension and also my shoulders are hyperextending in this position. So what I need to do here is I will ensure that I'm externally rotating the shoulders. I will ensure that I'm not hyperextending my elbows and I will remain at 80% of my range rather than going down all the way like this and compromising the joint stability. So this is what I mean by staying at 80% of your range. So when you do that, you will safeguard yourself from future injuries and this will also ensure that you can practice safely in the long term. Lastly, what hypermobile practitioners need to focus on is that they need to focus on proper muscular control, on proper muscle activation and engagement, and on stability. Now here I'll be demonstrating using Paschimottanasana as well as Falakasana or Santolanasana, which is commonly called as plank. Now if you are into Paschimottanasana, okay, and if you have reached your end range of stretch at the hamstrings, what you can do is you can simply curl the toes inwards and draw your heels towards your sit bones. So I repeat this once again. You will focus on drawing your heels in towards the sit bones and the moment you do this, you will feel some kind of contraction that has happened in your hamstrings. So you are preventing your hamstrings from being stretched completely. So having maintained this, now you will go into your asana. So this is one way to safeguard yourself. Now secondly, speaking of Falakasana or plank. Now here. So this is the plank posture. So for hypermobile practitioners, the first thing that they will do here is that they'll ensure that their fingers are spread. You will be gripping the mat really well with your fingertips, the tip of the thumb, the base of the fingers, as well as the base of the thumb. You will literally be clawing at your mat or you will be clawing against the floor. So this will prevent additional strains on your wrist. Also, you will ensure that you're turning the inside of the elbows towards each other, maintaining a slight micro bend. And then from here, you will think about drawing your upper arms towards each other. And the moment you do that, you will feel a tremendous activation that happens in your bicep muscles. So this way, you're ensuring that there is proper muscle engagement, activation and muscle control, which will go a long way in safeguarding your joints, in ensuring that your joints have the requisite stability always. So my friends, this was my bit about why injuries are happening in yoga asana and how do we go about preventing them. So I'd like to simply conclude by saying that please be mindful when you practice and see if you can align yourself with a deeper meaning, with a deeper purpose when you practice. And always remember that go for benefits, go for functionality when you practice rather than simply going for aesthetics. Thank you very much. Namaste.